Today, we are going to talk about Ansible troubleshooting, specifically about Windows Subsystem for Linux, error 0x80370102. Yeah, it's complicated. I'm Luca Berton, and welcome in today's episode of Ansible Pilot. This is the full error message that you might obtain whenever you run Windows Subsystem for Linux Ubuntu distribution. The best way of talking about troubleshooting is to jump in a live demo to show you practically the error and how to reproduce. So let's jump in a Windows laboratory with error 0x80370102. Yes, let's do it. Welcome to my Windows 10 machine. Now I will let you know how to install the Windows Subsystem for Linux. First of all, let me open the PowerShell, right-click Run as Administrator, then type the command WSL, like Windows for Subsystem for Linux, --install. This is a straightforward automatic installation process. As you can see, it's going to download the necessary packages and also enable the Windows feature that we need. So first of all, it set it up the virtual machine platform and is successfully installed. Then the Windows Subsystem for Linux and has been installed. Now is currently downloaded the kernel. The kernel is the part of the operating system that is communicating directly with the hardware, and now is going to be installed on the machine. After this, we can download the guest operating system. In my case, I choose the default, that is Ubuntu, but you can customize with -d, specifying your distribution. There are at the moment only a limited amount of distribution available, but we will see later on the video. This is only some waiting time because Windows is performing the operation by himself. As you see, we are nearly at 50% and it keeps going. Once all the steps are completed, we need only to perform a reboot, and we are expecting that Windows Subsystem for Linux will proceed and will be ready to use it. Now let's wait together to finish the completion of this step. The time is impacted by the network connection speed and, as usual, some also performance for your workstation. After the downloading, there is the verification of the package and then the installation performed in next step. Now let me do the reboot. I will do now, and let's see the result. Welcome to my machine that is successfully rebooted. If it doesn't start automatically, we can reach out the new distribution in the start menu from the Ubuntu, and it's going to perform some post-install operation. As you can see, it's going to install, and here we are. We have the error message, the one that we were expecting, the 0x WSL 0x80370102. As you can see, the description say the virtual machine could not be started because there are required feature that is not installed. Let me double check from the setting, from the Windows setting. Let's go to Program and Features and then reach out, turn Windows feature on and off. Specifically, we are looking for some required feature. In my case, the Windows Subsystem for Linux that is enabled, and the other required feature is under Hyper-V, that is Hyper-V platform, that is not possible to be enabled because is missed the second some technical detail of second memory address. And this feature might not be available for your CPU, or maybe you are using a virtualization technology that doesn't allow you to use this stuff. The workaround is to set the Windows subsystem for Linux on version 1, and I'm going to do using the PowerShell. As usual, right click, run as administrator. Then we can set with WSL. You can see all the parameter with --- help, but I'm going to use the WSL --- update to be sure that this utility is using the latest possible edition, and it is. Now let me specify WSL --, set the default --version to 1, because I would like to use WSL version 1. Then I can list the available distribution with --, list -o. In my case, I would like to use Ubuntu, so let me specify WSL --, install -d Ubuntu. And as you can see, the install process is going to restart from the previous step, and now is going to be successful. It's going to take some moment to start up the guest operating system, Ubuntu in my case, but you can choose from the list whatever you like. Please mind that only a limited distribution are available at the moment, and I'm expecting that the follow step is to ask to set the username and the password. Here we are. You need to create a new Unix username. In my case, I'm going to use Ansible Pilot, set up a new password, then retype for security reason, and then the distribution is booting up and ready to use. Good job, Windows. Now finally you can use your Linux Ubuntu machine inside Windows Subsystem for Linux. Yes, let's have fun. Now you know how to troubleshoot the error 0x80370101 of Windows Subsystem for Linux and how to fix it. Thank you for watching. Give me a thumbs up and see us in the next lesson. This video is part of our Ansible automation program. Sign up today on www.ansiblepilot.com for uninterrupted exclusive video and so much fun.